Hello? Mr. Smith?
Yes, I understand the project.
You want a modern, updated version of the nativity story?
The ones the kids will understand, in their own words.
Gotcha.
Now, when you say modern times, do you mean, like, today, Bethlehem?
Well, sir, I don't think you really want, you know, Mary and Joseph going around toting machine guns.
Okay. I got it. Bye.
Okay. Let's see. A modern version of the nativity story. Spice it up. Give it some oomph. Make it so the kids will enjoy it and understand it. Fair enough. I'm a professional writer. I should be able to bring this story to up to date, add a little 21st century into the mix. No problem. Okay, where should I start? Nativity. Mary and the angel. First, the angel tells Mary she will have a baby. Now, in the original version, she visited her in person. How will she tell her today? Will she visit her in person or try another method? How about collect the call from the angel? Do you accept the charge? No, that's ridiculous. Email? No. Telegram.
Hail Mary, stop. Blessed art thou, stop.
No, that doesn't work either. Well, looks like she'll have to visit her in person after all. Okay. In the original version, what did the angel say? Let's see.
Hail Mary, thou art highly favored, and the Lord is with you. You are truly blessed among all women.
Well, first off, King James, no one talks like that anymore. Let's try this.
Hello, Mary. You are...
Let's see. Highly favored. What would she say today? Highly favored. How about...
Hello, Mary. You are greatly esteemed.
No.
You're just great.
No.
Awesome.
No.
A cool woman.
Please, get real.
Hello, Mary. You are... highly favored.
Actually, I like highly favored. Highly favored it is.
Hello, Mary. You are highly favored, and the Lord is with you.
Okay. Blessed art thou among women.
You are seriously blessed.
No.
When it comes to blessings, lady, you take the cake.
No.
Among women, you are the cat's meow.
Come on. Think.
Hello, Mary. You are highly favored, and the Lord is with you. You are truly blessed among all women.
Once again, the original sounds good. Narrator says...
Mary heard the greeting and was bothered by it, wondering what strange type of greeting it was.
Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. Behold, you'll conceive and have a son. His name will be Jesus. He will be great.
Think modern. What was she saying today?
His name will be Jesus, and he will be the bomb.
No.
He will flat out rock.
No.
He'll be seriously great.
Close. Let's take seriously out for a second here.
He will be great.
He will be great. I guess that's ideal.
His name will be Jesus, and he will be great. And be called Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David.
And Mary says,
Behold God's servant, let it happen to me according to thy word.
Let's see. Nowadays she would say,
I'm your lady.
No.
Okay, where do I sign?
No.
Bring it.
Come on, man. Let's not be disrespectful here. How will she accept the idea?
Behold God's servant, let it happen to me according to thy word.
Fair enough. Probably best not to tamper too much with the original here. Okay, cue the lights, some soft music in the background, and...
Mary heard the greeting and was troubled by it, wondering what strange type of greeting it was.
Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive and have a son, and his name will be Jesus, and he will be great, and be called Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
How can this happen, since I am a virgin?
The Holy Ghost will rest upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Remember, Mary, all things are possible with God.
Behold, God's servant, let it happen to me according to thy word.
Narrator says,
in those days, Caesar Augustus gave the decree that all the world should be taxed, so everyone returned to his own hometown to register.
Okay, so Mary is pregnant, just about to give birth. They're on foot.
We certainly didn't walk the whole way.
But I can't have a donkey on stage. Well, it is a kid's play. So how about... No, that would ruin the effect. We can't get silly.
So wrong.
Well, I have to say, I have it so that they just arrived. She is already dismounted. Joseph goes to check on a room at the inn. The Bible doesn't describe this exchange. I guess I'll just have to wing it.
Hello, are you the innkeeper?
Certainly not King Herod.
Mr. Smith said to add some humor here. Maybe it will work here.
We just flew in from Nazareth, and boy, our arms are tired.
No. No, that's ridiculous. How about...
Take my wife, please.
I don't think so. Let's get to the point.
Hello, are you the innkeeper?
Yes, sir.
I'm in desperate need of room. My wife is having a baby.
Hey, ask them if they have any cable.
No, that won't work.
I'm in desperate need of a room. My wife is having a baby.
Wish I could help you, sir. Christmas is our busiest time of the year, and unless you have a reservation, you'll have to go elsewhere.
No! Man, humor just doesn't seem to work here. Let's try this.
Well, we have no room in the inn left. We do have a stinky barn in the back between our backs tonight.
The barn? Do we look like cattle to you?
It's just not a funny story. How can you take a story and make it funny? But it has to be funny, or the kids won't understand it. But I can keep it serious.
Can you at least call me a cab?
Okay, you're a cab.
Why does the dialogue have to be so hard to write here? Let's wait on dialogue. How will the stage look? That would work. I like to sing without dialogue. Okay, what's next? Aha! The angels and the shepherds. Three shepherds, one angel. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night.
Hey guys, have y'all counted the sheep yet?
I keep counting, but I keep falling asleep.
Now that's kind of funny.
Hey guys, we're cutting the wool off the sheep in the morning.
Okay, sheep. Anyway,
we'll be moving the flock tomorrow.
Yes, I heard. Did it
hurt?
That's enough of that.
Gentlemen, I have a question.
Gentlemen, too polite.
All right, listen up, bozos.
No. Nope, too harsh.
Hey guys, can I ask something?
Sure, what is it?
Have you ever seen an angel before?
No, why do you ask?
Let's see. The original says,
"Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people."
Let's tidy that up a bit here. Oops, took it too far. Try it again.
Don't be afraid. I bring you great news. It will change the world. The Savior has been born tonight in Bethlehem. He is Christ the Lord.
Where will we find him?
I get it to the park!
Oops, took it too far. Try again here.
You will find the baby wrapped in a swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Swaddling clothes?
Swaddling clothes. How exactly does one swaddle?
You will find the baby wrapped in a warm blanket, lying in a manger.
That will work. Okay, the narrator says,
suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God.
How do I show multitude of angels? A backdrop? 1,000 extras? I got it. I use music. Okay, let's see if this will work.
Suddenly there appeared with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God. The shepherds gathered quickly to follow the star of Bethlehem to witness the wondrous event.
Let's go see this wonderful thing that has happened in Bethlehem.
You know, this is a remarkable story. It's so complete. Why update? Why try to modernize it? Voicemail. Hello. This message is from Mr. Smith. I've come to the conclusion that there's no reason to modernize the Nativity story. I mean, God got it right the first time. I believe the kids will understand it just fine. Goodbye. Well, no, wait. To begin,
what a story. The God of creation left him heaven and came down to be a helpless baby. Truly, what a wonderful story.
For unto us a child is born,
unto us a son is given,
and his government shall be upon his shoulder,
and his name will be called
Wonderful
Counselor,
the Mighty God,
the Everlasting Father,
the Prince of Peace.
And of his government and peace there shall be no end.
Wonderful job here tonight.